World Kidney Day is observed on the second Thursday of March every year. So this year, the theme for this day is Kidney Health for All. Now, how does one ensure healthy kidneys? Is it the role of the diet or is it some lifestyle modifications that have to take place? Well, we'll try and find out in this 1 hour. Welcome to Healthy India. I'm Lottie Alaric. And I'm very happy to have with me Dr. N.P. Gupta, who's the chairperson of the urology department at the Medanta Medicity Hospital. I welcome you to the show, sir.
Thank you.
Sitting next to him is Dr. Gurdeep Kaur, Department of Dietetics at the AIIMS Hospital. I welcome you to the show,
ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
So, well, folks, before we begin asking questions to our panelists here, let's all take a look at this report.
Renal failure or kidney failure is a situation in which the kidneys fail to function adequately. It can be acute or chronic in form. Either form may be due to a large number of other medical problems. Biochemically, it is typically detected by an elevated serum creatinine. In the science of physiology, renal failure is described as a decrease in the glomerular filtration rate. When the kidneys malfunction, problems frequently encountered are abnormal fluid levels in the body, deranged acid levels, abnormal levels of potassium, calcium, phosphate, hematuria, which is the blood in the urine, and in the longer term, anemia. Long-term kidney problems have significant repercussions on other diseases such as cardiovascular disease. Complications include heart failure, pulmonary edema, and high potassium levels. Chronic failure usually results from long-term kidney diseases. The blood becomes too acidic, bones can lose calcium, and nerves can degenerate. The kidneys can sustain life until they lose about 90% of their function. If one is removed, the other increases in size and functions to compensate. Failure of both usually requires dialysis or kidney transplant. If detected in time, kidneys can definitely be saved.
Well, friends, we are joined by two more doctors now. So I take this opportunity of welcoming Professor Dr. Amlesh Seth, Department of Urology from AIIMS. I welcome you to the show, sir. Sitting next to him is Professor Dr. D. Bhomik, who's from the Department of Nephrology, again from AIIMS. So I welcome you too.
Thank you.
Well, to begin with, let me start with you, Dr. Seth. First and foremost, I think we need to understand the function of a kidney. So what is the function of a kidney, if you can just explain in very simple terms?
Yeah, that is relatively easy to understand. We get in a lot of toxins through our diet, mainly through our diet, and some through the absorption through the respiratory tract. And a lot of toxins are also produced inside our body due to metabolism. All these toxins have to go out of the system, and kidneys are the most efficient filters, and they have some active metabolism also to excrete all these harmful products from our body.
Right. So, Dr. Bhomik, would you want to add anything to that at all?
Apart from this very important and vital functions which Dr. Amlesh said mentioned, one very important function is that kidney is a balancing organ. It also maintains the pH of the blood, maintains the acid-base balance, maintains the fluid electrolyte balance, and very importantly, it also maintains the body's blood pressure. BP control, the kidney plays a very vital role, which people often, you know, don't remember. And apart from that, it produces a hormone called erythropoietin, which maintains the blood hemoglobin, and that's why in chronic kidney disease, one important symptom is tiredness, fatigueness, because of low hemoglobin. And then it keeps the bones strong because it activates the vitamin D which we ingest or we make in the skin. This is activated both by the liver and the kidney. So kidney plays a very vital role in these aspects as well.
Right. So Dr. Gupta, now this year's theme is that kidney health for all. Now what does this really mean? Is there a way wherein one can do something wherein you can have healthy kidneys?
No, to know that your kidney are functioning normally, it is very important that one should have a periodic checkup of the kidney function test to see whether the blood urea and serum creatinine, these are the two normal tests which we are done. So whether these tests are normal or not. And if somebody has got a specific regions which usually causes the damage to the kidney, like diabetes or hypertension, And in these cases, there should be more regular checkup should be done periodically. I don't say that every month, but once a year or once in 6 months. And those who have got these disease, then if the values are abnormal, then it is better to check early so that some preventive measures can be taken.
Right. Now, Gurdeep, diet plays a very important role in our health, I mean, considering just about any organ of the body. Now, as far as kidney is concerned, as a preventive measure, as Dr. Gupta also just mentioned, what would be the role of diet here?
Well, if we are talking about the general population, we're not talking about kidney patients general population as such. Well, you ask me, you plan a diet and you follow a diet and that will prevent you not having kidney disease. There's no such diet.
All right.
But one has to understand that two of the major causes of kidney disease is hypertension and diabetes. And in both these diseases, obesity is a major culprit.
That's right.
And that has a direct
role link with it.
Obesity. So the first thing one has to really take care of is to prevent obesity. Now, a small tip for the people who want to reduce is, like, usually they think that you have to create a negative balance. So what they do is they reduce the intake, thinking that whatever is stored inside will be utilized. Now, it is not as simple an equation as that. Now, when you reduce your food intake, the body thinks that probably there is some famine condition coming. So it goes into a conservative mode and it reduces its expenditure. So then there is again a status quo.
Disbalance, right?
So you have to create a negative balance. So in that case, what you really need to do is to increase on your physical activity. Now, when you increase your physical activity, you increase your number of muscle cells. Now, these muscle cells are working cells. Now, they say ki humse kaam kara rahe ho, hume khana do. Now, at that point, reduce the outer intake so that the body is forced to utilize whatever is stored inside. So just not the diet,
right.
It is diet along with good amount of physical exercise that can prevent obesity. So the preventing obesity is the first point. Second point is taking care of the salt. Now people know salt in relation to hypertension, but what they really do not know, a very high salt diet can also help in making the kidney stones. Right? So that is again bad. And then these days you have many salt. Different kind of salts, you know, you have light salt, you have
Luna
salt and all that. So as far as the general population is concerned, any salt is all right. But then as far as the renal population is concerned, we say totally no to them for the reason that these Luna salt or the light salt, they're replaced by potassium, which is not good.
Which again not good.
So
all
taking care of the salt and then the processed food and then the hydration point. You know, the number of glasses is not important. The color of your urine, the amount of urine, will tell
that
you what
decide.
Is your status. So that is very
right. I think that's really very well explained. Okay, now Dr. Seth, so as she said, you know, diabetics are the ones who could be at risk, and then people who are hypertensive could also be at risk. So let's just take this one by one. Now, for diabetic patients, the moment one learns that one is suffering of diabetes, so what is the care that must go into taking care of the kidneys?
Actually, I am not an endocrinologist, but still I can tell you that the diabetics have to be very particular about everything. It's a lifestyle. The entire lifestyle needs to be modified. The intake should be measured. The sugars should come down significantly. The fast sugars lead to a rapid sugar rise, and a persistently high sugar level damages the kidneys. And apart from that, the high sugars would also lead to an increased production of insulin in the body. That also leads to further deposition of fat. And in the diet, they have to take, the diabetics have to take care of their diet, their activity, and they have to take care of their medicines also. And there should be a proper diet chart, and medicines and diet chart should match. Their whatever medicine the patient is on, whether it is an oral hypoglycemic tablet or it is insulin, the duration of insulin and the duration of action of the tablet has to be understood by the patient, and the patient has to understand the concept of caloric intake and the food exchanges, that this much food is equivalent to these many calories, and everything has to be taken in a regular
balanced
form. And physical activity. Yeah, she has emphasized on physical activity, because as she has said, with physical activity there is development of muscles. The muscles consume a lot of sugar, and at the time of need, the muscles can provide sugar in the form of what is known as gluconeogenesis.
Okay.
And
okay.
So they are buffers. The muscle mass is a good buffer for sugar. Hmm. They prevent both hyperglycemia, increased sugar level, as well as reduced sugar level. Hmm. And for a diabetic is prone to both.
Hmm. All right. So, well, folks, it's time for us to slip into a very short break right now. When we come back, we'll also be ready to take your calls. So do remember that today we are talking about chronic kidney disease. Now, the numbers are running on your screen, but I would repeat them. 1-800-115-3314 and 2303-5420. Do remember that today we are only talking about chronic kidney disease. Welcome back. This is Healthy India, and today we are talking about chronic kidney disease. So we just learned that diabetics could be at a risk of developing some kind of kidney diseases, and I would want Dr. Bhumik to kindly take this further.
Yes, as Dr. Seth said, that we need to take care of the blood sugars very well. Mm. Now, apart from that, the other aspect is the blood pressure control. Mm. The blood pressure control should be very optimal, and we want it to be around 130-80. We can use any of the drugs to control BP, but there are certain drugs which, apart from controlling blood pressure, they also have a nephroprotective effect. Mm-hmm. So we call them as the ACE inhibitors. Mm. So these are the drugs which help in reducing the load on the kidney and help in protecting their life. So under supervision of your physician, your nephrologist, it's important that they are initiated on these drugs at an early stage so that the life of the kidney can be prolonged. Mm. Besides, as Professor Gupta mentioned, that diabetics need to have a regular urine check. Mm. Now, this is very important because initially there is a hyperfiltration stage and there is a greater load on the kidney. The membrane gets damaged. Mm-hmm. And so what happens is the protein starts leaking out. So one needs to pick up this protein leak early so that we know that, you know, you are in trouble. Mm. So initial stage, you can pick up what is called as a microalbumin, which means basically small amounts of albumin, which later on goes into macroalbumin, means large amounts are excreted. So regular monitoring of the GFR, as Dr. Seth and Dr. Gupta mentioned, and urine examination for microalbumin and albuminuria is very important. Mm. So if one takes, it has to be a holistic approach, sugar control, BP control, nephroprotective drugs, and good check of your urine.
Right. And also, would you like to say something more on the theme for this year being kidney
health? Yes, I think that is a very important theme. As mentioned, this World Kidney Day started 10 years back, and every year there's been a special theme. Second year it was that the CKD is a common disease, it is a harmful disease, but it is also preventable and maybe even treatable. So every year we've had nice taglines, and this time we have this kidney health for all. So what we basically mean is that, unfortunately, all over the world and even within the country, there's a lot of inequity regarding providing kidney health services to the population. Large segment of the population is not able to get the kidney services in form of prevention and ultimately treatment in form of dialysis. So we want to see to it that all the population gets access to kidney treatment, dialysis and transplants. So this is the awareness we want to increase this year.
That's very important. Okay, so now, Dr. Gupta, the other group is the one who is suffering from hypertension. Now, this is again a very vulnerable group, and also the number of people suffering of hypertension is only on an increase. So as a doctor, what would you want to say here?
No, I will say that they should have again a regular checkup of their blood pressure.
Right.
And those who have got a higher blood levels as blood pressure, 130 or 80 and above that, then there should be adequate medication to control the blood pressure. The salt intake should be reduced in these cases, and they should also have a regular checkup for their kidney function as well as heart function to see that there is no side effects of the blood pressure on these organs. And as for the drugs, Dr. Bhumik has already mentioned that there are nephroprotective drugs, and they should be given to these hypertensives so that the kidney function is not affected in these cases.
Right. Also, I would want you to take this opportunity of telling us that what is a malfunctioning kidney? Like, what would happen if the kidney is not really functioning well? What are the signs and symptoms that a person himself or herself would be able to notice?
See, as you have shown in your visuals also initially, that up to 90%. So the if the kidney function goes down to that level, the symptoms may not appear actually.
Okay,
so initially, till the kidney functions are 50%, I won't say 90%. So there may not be any symptoms.
At all.
So once the blood urea and started rising in the body, then only the symptoms start coming. So we should not wait for the symptoms to come.
True.
But we should have a regular checkup of the blood urea and serum creatinine to see what is the function of the kidneys. And if blood urea creatinine is high, then we should also do a nuclear medicine test that is called glomerular filtration rate. That gives us the accurate the functioning of the each kidney actually, how they are functioning. And so according to that,
is this also a blood test or what kind of a test?
It's an isotope test with which we give an isotope that is excreted by the kidney.
Okay.
And we know the function of the kidney. What is the actual glomerular filtration rate? Normally is 120 ml per minute.
Mm-hmm.
And here we see how much is the filtration rate.
Mm.
And if filtration rate is low, when it goes down to less than 30 or 40, then only the symptoms start coming. So
okay,
we should not
okay.
wait till that is.
That's right. That's right. I think that's a very important point, that please do not wait for the symptoms to set in, because the damage could have been done by then. So if we, as a preventive measure, maybe you could get those tests done initially. Well, we have with us Deepika from Chhattisgarh at this point. So Deepika, can you hear me, please?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, kindly go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. Aap sabko good evening. मैम, मैं डॉक्टर नॉमिक से पूछना चाहती हूँ मैम कि मेरे पापा की एज 57 इयर्स है. उनको हाइपरटेंशन है पिछले 8-10 साल से. वो उसकी रेगुलर दवाई खाते हैं और वो कंट्रोल में भी रहता है. उनका 2-3 साल से क्रिएटिनिन 1.4 आता है, लेकिन अभी पिछले 2 महीने से वो 1.6 हो गया था, यानी 2 महीने पहले 1.6 हो गया था. तो जो उनके नेफ्रोलॉजिस्ट हैं, उन्होंने उनको रीनोसेफ और सोबिसिस नाम की 500 नाम की मेडिसिन दी थी, लेकिन उन्होंने वो दवाई नहीं खाई कि शरीर को आदत हो जाती बोलकर. तो अभी लेकिन उन्होंने अपना क्रिएटिनिन कराया तो अभी वो 1.5 आया है. पिछले महीने 1.4 था.
तो आपका सवाल क्या है दीपिका? व्हाट्स योर क्वेश्चन
मैम? तो मैं ये पूछना चाहती हूँ कि वो दवाई खाएं कि नहीं खाएं, या दवाई खाने और नहीं खाने से क्या नुकसान या फायदा है?
थैंक यू वेरी मच दीपिका. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, आई थिंक आई वुड लाइक टू टेक दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी ऑफ टेलिंग द व्यूअर्स दैट व्हेन योर डॉक्टर टेल्स यू समथिंग टू डू, जस्ट फॉलो द ऑर्डर्स टू द टी. डोंट स्टार्ट थिंकिंग ऑन योर सेल्फ कि ज्यादा दवाई खाने से ऐसा होगा या नहीं खाने से ऐसा होगा. लेट द डॉक्टर टेक दैट डिसीजन प्लीज, बिकॉज ही और शी इज ट्रेन्ड to check you and they know exactly what is to be done with you. So that's one little piece of advice that I wanted to give. Over to you, Dr.
Yes, sir. Actually, उन्होंने जो सवाल किया है actually काफी तरीके से सही भी है. डॉक्टर ने दो दवाई दी है अपार्ट फ्रॉम बीपी कंट्रोल के. बीपी कंट्रोल दवाई तो लेना बहुत आवश्यक है, उसमें तो कोई शक ही नहीं है. प्रॉब्लम इज रिगार्डिंग सोबोसिस एंड द अदर रिनोसेव. सोबोसिस जो है इज बेसिकली सोडा बाइकार्ब, यानी बेकिंग सोडा है. एंड दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड, जरूरी है जब बॉडी में एसिड ज्यादा बन जाता है. सो इफ ब्लड टेस्ट में पता चला कि एसिड है ज्यादा, बाइकार्बोनेट लो है, देन सोबोसिस इज जस्टिफाइड ड्रग. तो बहुत महंगा भी नहीं है और तो लेना चाहिए. और नाउ केस टू केस बेसिस. नाउ जो अहम सवाल है रिगार्डिंग रिनोसेव, तो नाम ना बहुत कैची नाम है. सेव, इट सेव द किडनी. बट लेट मी वेरी फ्रैंक, आई एम नॉट वेरी कन्विंस्ड एंड आई माई सेल्फ, मैं ज्यादातर देता नहीं हूँ. बट देन एज यू सेड, सम फिजिशियंस देते हैं, कोई हार्म नहीं है इसमें. बट कितना सेव करेगा, दैट इज कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल. एंड इफ कॉस्ट इज एन इशू, आई मीन इवन इफ यू ओमिट इट, इट्स ओके.
ऑल्सो मे बी एंड इन केस, इवन इफ यू हैव अ डाउट, यू कैन ऑलवेज गो टू अनदर डॉक्टर एंड गेट अ सेकेंड ओपिनियन एंड अ थर्ड इफ यू रियली वॉन्ट वन. सो बट जस्ट फॉलो वॉट योर डॉक्टर्स से, दैट्स द ओनली पॉइंट दैट आई वॉन्ट टू मेक. ओके, कमिंग टू यू गुरदीप, नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट डायट, यू नो देयर इज ऑलवेज दिस thinking among in people's minds that protein rich foods are going to be bad for kidneys. So are protein rich foods really bad for the kidneys?
No, not really.
Okay.
You see, protein is talked about in the kidney function because it's the kidneys which take care of the excretion of the protein product. So the general notion is reduce the protein so that kidneys are less loaded, right? But one should understand that even the body of a patient who has kidney disease needs some amount of protein.
Right.
You see, your enzymes are protein, your hormones are protein, your antibodies are protein. So for so many different functions, we need protein. So there should be sufficient amount so that on one side, the body's requirement is met and on the other side, the kidneys are not loaded. Now, the problem with we Indians is we always, you know, go and read the literature in the net and just want to copy. Now one has to really see how much is it good enough for we Indians. They Western people talk about lowering the protein because they take a very high protein
diet.
That's right. Right? We Indians, we do not take a very high protein diet. For us, the quantity is not a problem. We already have a lower quantity, you know. The problem is the quality.
That's right.
Now one has to understand that the good quality protein is the one which has a composition similar to your body protein. So they are utilized very efficiently. So we ask our patients, please have some amount of milk and milk products. Egg whites are the best kind of protein. And if you ask me, if I have got to recommend something for all the renal patients, I would say 2 egg whites on everyday basis for everybody. This is because egg whites are very, very good quality protein, and also they're very, very low in phosphates and potassium, which is not present in any other protein. Now, we Indians, what we do the moment we come to know that we have some renal problem, the first thing we cut down is all the good quality protein, which should not
happen. Now, I'll have to come back to you because right now we have with us a viewer from West Bengal. This is Mr. S. Bhattacharya. So, Mr. Bhattacharya, welcome to the show.
Yeah.
Yes. Can you hear me, please?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, welcome to the show and kindly go ahead. What's your question?
Actually, my question is that my elder brother recurring kidney stone.
Recurring kidney stones.
जितने पर जो लिथोटिप्सी होता है तो साल भर एक साल बाद बाद इनको लिथोटिप्सी करना पड़ता है तो मैं जानना चाहता हूँ कि इसका रेमेडी क्या है.
ओके, थैंक यू फॉर द क्वेश्चन. आई वुड वांट डॉक्टर गुप्ता टू काइंडली टेक दिस.
See, the recurrent urinary stone means he is forming the stone again. So we have to do some investigations to find out why he is forming the stone again. So we do the studies of his serum calcium, uric acid, phosphate, and also 24 hours urinary calcium, uric acid, phosphate, oxalate, and citrate nowadays. So with these, we will come to know whether there is any abnormality or not. If we find that serum calcium is high, in that case, we have to check for the parathyroid hormone also. And if we find out that there is a cause for the formation of the stone, then we like to correct that particular defect. Otherwise, overall, if anybody who is forming the stone, the best preventive measure is to take the plenty of fluids orally. It is not just the water, but what we advise, not the general water, but we say filtered water has to be taken along with a glass of juice or nibu pani or watermelon. So this excess of the fluid intake is very important to keep the urine diluted so that the crystals don't come together and they do not form the stones. So he should go to a particular doctor to get properly investigated, and if there is already existing stone in the body, that has to come out first actually, because that forms a nidus or source where the crystals go on depositing and forming more stones.
That's right. Well, so I think that's really explained in detail, but we'll have to slip into yet another break in this program. But when we come back, we'll be taking this forward, and the lines would still be open, and the numbers are 1-800-111-5314 and 2303-5420. So we'll see you right after this break. Do remember, we are talking about chronic kidney disease today.